Hi friends, Miggi from Figma here with another study hall. Today we're going to be talking about the Figma community. It's a space where you can download templates, plugins, and widgets that others have created, and it's an amazing resource if you're just getting started. It's also a great space to share the amazing things that you make in Figma and FigJam to help out others. Today I'm going to be walking through a few concepts. First, we're going to explore the Figma community, then I'm going to show you how to duplicate a community file. Next, we'll be creating your own community profile, then we'll be showing you how to make a file and publish it out to the community so that you can help others. The first thing I'm going to do is navigate over to figma.com/community. That's going to take me to this page where there's a whole host of categories that I can click into to look for different templates I can download and learn from. The first thing that I'm actually going to do is I'm going to head up to community and I'm going to search community. I'm going to type in education. That's going to take me to a search results page. In the search results page, I can search by files and templates, plugins, widgets, but I'm going to choose creators and head on over to the page Figma for Education. This page here, accessed by going to figma.com/@education, you will see a list of templates made specifically with the educator in mind. I'm going to navigate over here. I'm going to find the syllabus template in FigJam. I'm going to go ahead and open that up. So this page here, I'm going to be able to browse it. I can zoom in and I can zoom out and get a sense of what this file is before I actually want to get a copy of my own. So if I do want to duplicate this file into drafts, all I need to do is head up here and choose get a copy. When I click on that, what that's going to do, it's going to grab a copy of that document and place it inside of my drafts folder. That's going to allow me to customize it, change it up as needed before I might share it with my students. So let's say, for instance, I don't want this thumbnail. I'm also going to read through these instructions and I might not want those instructions for when I'm sharing this with my students, so I can also delete that. Here I can begin to customize everything that I want, so I can change this text here. So let's say my course name is Design 101. Let's say here I'm going to change some information about me as an instructor. I'm going to change this to Professor Cardona. And so this is fully customizable. Anything that I want to remove, I can just select and remove. I can even adjust some of these things here. So I think that that looks great. Now, if I want to move this file to a place where my students can access it, what I'm going to do is head back to my files. If I click on drafts, so let's say here, I click on my drafts folder, I can see the syllabus template in FigJam. What I can do is I can move that over to a project inside of my education team so that when I click on it, here it now is, and it says syllabus template in FigJam. I can right click, choose rename, and I will say course syllabus for Design 101. So now that it is in this team, students will be able to access this file. Now that we've explored Figma community and duplicated a community file, let's talk about creating our own community profile so then this way we can share what we've created with others. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna head back to files. I'm gonna come up over here to the top right. I'm gonna click on my account. Go over to settings. Here in settings, you'll see that there's account, but then there's also a community tab. Here in the community tab, it says create your own public profile. I'm going to claim my handle. So here I could type in whatever handle I want. I'm going to type in Miggi Study Hall. And I can see that it's available. So I'm going to create that profile. Now that the profile is created, I can actually view it. So I can see that this profile doesn't have anything added to it yet. However, I can begin by adding a description and I can say my class file shares. I can add a location such as New York. I can add a website URL. So let's just say figma.com. Let me throw in my Twitter handle and my Instagram handle. Now that I'm ready to get going, what I can do is I can actually follow someone else. So let's go follow Figma's official account. So I'm going to go to figma.com/@Figma. And on this page, I can give Figma a follow. If I want to go back to my community profile page, I can click up here and choose my community profile. So now I'm back. let's start to think about if I want to publish a file of my very own to the Figma community. I'm going to head on back over to my files, and you will see that I have this course syllabus file. Let's say I want to make that available to others to learn from. Let's open that up. Come up here and click share. So I can click on publish to community. And you'll see that this file, because it has been previously downloaded from the Figma community, it will now publish as a remix of the syllabus template. So I'm going to hit publish. And here I can change some of the details so I can describe this and say course syllabus example for my class. I can put in a few tags so I can say syllabus. And I'm going to set myself as the creator. And let's go ahead and publish this. Now I can see that this has been published. Let me go ahead and view that page. I can see that this is the page now for that syllabus that I modified, Course Syllabus for Design 101 by Miggi. And I can see the other files associated with it. If I click here, you will see that I have this file now available on my community profile. If I go back to this file in the community and I want to edit the original, I have the options down here. So as long as I'm logged into community as myself, I have the opportunity just to edit this page. So if I just want to edit the title, or what I can do is actually open the original file and make any adjustments. So let's say if I want to make an adjustment here where I'm going to change my name to Professor Miggi, and let's say I want to update this file, go to share, publish to community, and you will see that I have the options here to unpublish that file or just publish that update. I'm going to publish that update. Now I can make any other additional changes. So I'm going to click publish. And now that that has been published, if I go view page, I can see where that has now been published and it has my update. So I think that that's pretty cool. One thing that I like to do with my community files is add a thumbnail so it's more easily recognizable. Let's head back over to my file browser. I'm in my project. I'm going to create a new design file. In this design file, I'm going to create a new frame. I'm going to press the F key, draw out a frame. I'm going to set the width of this frame to 1920 by 960. 1920 by 960. And then inside of the frame, I'm going to make sure that I have a safe area of 1600 by 960. So I can easily draw another frame within the frame. I'm going to title this safe area. And I'm also going to set this to, let's say, 1600 by 960. And the reason is this helps you identify the visual area of your thumbnail. So I'm going to hit Shift R, and just so then this way we can kind of see exactly where that is. So I'm going to draw those points out. So this is going to be the visible area of the thumbnail. However, this is going to be the full size of the thumbnail. I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to select frame one, and I'm going to set that fill to whatever color I want it to be. So let's make that blue, and I'm going to put in here the title of that file. Let's just say design. Let's make that a little bit bigger. I'm going to select that text. Let's say 200, there we go. I'm gonna say design 101. And if I want to, I can bold it. So Command B, and I can center it. And then I can come down here. Let's make this a little bit smaller. And let's say Professor Cardona. So now if I want to align it there a little to the left. So this thumbnail is ready to go. I'm gonna call this thumbnail. When you're going to publish Figma files, all you need to do to set the thumbnail is right click and choose set as thumbnail. So this will now be the thumbnail of this file. So if I go back to my files, you'll see that thumbnail there. However, if we want to bring this over to FigJam, I'm going to copy this. Let's go back over to our FigJam file. I can add this here and I can even add something, let's say like another line here, and I could say, you know, syllabus. There we go. So now I can hop in here, I can right click this and I can set this as my thumbnail. when I go to share and publish to community, you will see that this will have a nice community thumbnail. Let's go ahead and publish that update. Now that that's done, I can view the page and you can see that we have this nice thumbnail. Creating files for the community is just a great way to get visibility, to help others. So if there's a particular activity that you would like to share with other educators, sharing that to the community, sharing that link is a great way to do so. Now that we've covered all of these community basics, such as exploring the Figma community, duplicating a community file, making a community profile, as well as creating a file and publishing it, I just want to highlight some profiles that you might want to check out. So figma.com/@figma, that's going to be Figma's official page. You can also check out figma.com/@education. Those are files that we're publishing specifically for educators. Also check out @figjam. There's going to be tons of FigJam whiteboarding resources there, so activities that you can take a look at, as well as figma.com/@Miggi. That's my own personal community profile page. So if you're looking for inspiration on the types of activities that you can make, let's take one last look at FigJam. So figma.com/@FigJam. And what's cool about this is there are tons of resources, tons of activities. So different types of mappings, different types of group project process. Make sure you check this out. Also check out my own page @Miggi, where I have a number of different activities that you can find and be inspired by, as well as Remix. So hopefully you found this helpful. And as always, happy designing.